What's Marshall Wharf Brewing from Belfast, Maine doing going to Scotland? We have a unique opportunity based on a relationship with Single Malt TV and Rob Draper, who is introducing us to the wonderful world of Scotland, and in particular a couple of small distilleries and some breweries over there. The biggest opportunity for us that we found is the opportunity to get some single malt scotch barrels to actually visit a distillery, in particular Bowmore, and check out their barrel vault and possibly secure some of their single malt whiskey barrels that we'll be able to bring in to the Port of Portland and then use here for our beers. How long are we going to be in Scotland? We have about 7 days on the ground, and from the moment we get there, we'll be doing things like tasting our beers that we're bringing over with us with one of the leading Scotch whiskey experts in the world, Charlie McLean. That'll be in Edinburgh. We will also be traveling on the ferry across to Islay, where we'll be spending the bulk of our time, particularly at Bowmore, as well as with Martin Nuet, who we are going to be doing some pairing of our beers with some of her cooking. She's a world-class chef known as the Whiskey Chef. We'll be visiting the Islay Brewery, where I look forward to my head brewer, Dan McGovern, spending some time with the brewer there, tasting our beers, as well as maybe getting some insights into how we can build some recipes that will do really well aging in the barrels that we're hoping to secure from the distilleries on Islay. The impact that this will have on Maine will be obviously a lot of attention focused on craft beer, not just in Maine, but we hope in Maine, but also in America. And barrel aging isn't anything new. There's been breweries in the U.S. that have been doing this for quite a while, mostly with bourbon barrels. Some breweries on the West Coast have been able to secure wine barrels. We're really interested in this relationship that we hope to develop with the single malt scotch industry. And in particular, Bowmore has a relationship with Maine already, where Bowmore single malt scotch whiskey gets brought into Maine. Actually, the importer is here in Maine, White Rock Distillers in Lewiston. They bring it in bulk, they bottle it. So that's, again, another unique aspect of what we're trying to do with the barrels that we're getting. Well, I'm all about the butt, and that would be the, the sherry butt, of course. We've used the bourbon barrels here already and to great success with our barrel-aged beers. What we're hoping to be able to acquire are the more difficult to get, also larger. A butt is a measurement, generally in the 127 to 128 gallon size. Spanish oak versus American oak. Bourbon barrels are charred, whereas sherry barrels are toasted. So we're very excited about the possibility of being able to work with that type of a cask. I use the term butt very tongue-in-cheek. When we get casks here, especially if we get the sherry cask, as far as the time frame or how long we'll age them, it's going to be somewhat of a crapshoot. We've learned with the bourbon barrels that we really have to test the beers as they're aging, maybe every month or every couple of months. I imagine with the sherry casks or the sherry butts, we'll have to do the exact same thing. And that's why it's so important that we're going to Scotland. It's why it's so important we're meeting with some breweries and brewers who have had success aging beer in these particular casks from these distilleries, because we'll gain insights that will help us from the very beginning when we build a recipe, and we can build a recipe that will benefit from aging in those casks. We're going to be shooting stuff every day. We're going to be uploading to all of our social media sites. We actually will also be having a live broadcast. The last night that we're in Scotland, we'll be doing an on-camera webcast that will be broadcast all over the world, but in particular, it will be right here at Three Tides, which is where we are right now in Belfast, right around 4:30 on Saturday, the 9th of June. We'll have that broadcast here live, and people will be able to log on. They can text us questions. We'll be able to get those and hopefully answer them. And because it's the last night of our visit while we're there, we hope to be in just the best shape, of course. We'll be broadcasting from Charlie McLean's office, which I've heard is world class. Obviously, I'm sure is saturated with samples and various single malts that we'll be able to try. But of course, we'll be talking about our trip, who we've met, what we've done, and what we hope to bring back with us.